Fascinating. You've said that one of the most poignant moments for you was shooting Elvis backstage, just prior to going on stage. Tell us a little bit about that sequence.
Well, it became a very poignant moment. My cameraman and I, and we were very close and we'd worked together for many years at that time, Don Stern, who was a magnificent cameraman. He and I, we decided that we would walk with Elvis to the stage entrance. So Don walked backwards and I held him around around him to make sure that he didn't fall or stumble over something. And we walked very slowly backwards, as Elvis at that time had grown accustomed to us and he liked us. So he trusted us. So he just kept on walking and we kept on being very close around him. And then when he got to the stairs leading up to the stage, he stopped and we were very close on him. And he reached out for his Coca-Cola, took a sip and handed it out. And then the makeup artist did a little bit of last finishing off with his makeup. And then he bowed his head and prayed. And that was, of course, the moment where we were very, very close. And then he lifted his head, made that sign of his, and off he went. And that became probably a very, very important moment because it showed everybody that he was a devout Christian.
And a lot more humble maybe than people would think because he was so supremely confident on the stage.
He was very, very lovely and a very kind man.
So you would see him regularly during this two-week period. What would you talk about with Elvis?
We didn't talk. We had this little thing going on that I was still a redhead in those days, not an old lady with white hair, but I was a redhead. And he would always recognize the camera and me next to the camera. So he would come always towards me and he said, "Hello, darling." And I would say, "Hello, Elvis." And then he would give me a little squeeze in my hand and then walk away.
He almost seemed ready to go.
I think he was there for everybody else and he kept on putting on a brave face. I think he was tired. I think he was, that good old English word, weary. He was weary.
Over the years, the Elvis estate has released mountains of material, unreleased material, yet they've held off on releasing the entire Elvis in concert performance. They've always said Elvis was sick, the implication being we don't really want people to remember him that way. As someone who worked on that program, do you think it should have been released or should be released now, 40 years later?
Well, I was showing clips mainly from my part of the show, in Bad Nauheim last year, in front of, I think, maybe was it 1,000 or 1,500 Elvis Presley fans. They all loved every minute of it. And they all said, yes, he was overweight. Yes, he was sweaty. Yes, he was maybe not remembering his lyrics or whatever. But it didn't matter because the dynamic that came from this man and the love that they showed him still 40 years later in Bad Nauheim, I think that what CBS should have done originally, they should have simply said, okay, let's cut the show. Let's make it shorter. Let's take the best, and I had already told them which angles I thought was good enough, and then fill it up with more of our documentary material, make it more like a day in Elvis's life on tour. Then they could have done it, but it was too late and they didn't, and the concert footage, a lot of it was unusable. But I think that the time is gone, the time has passed. I think this is a moment in Elvis's and my life, actually, where two people who didn't know each other, who never got to know each other, but who had an understanding of mutual respect. And I will always respect him and I will always remember him as this kind, wonderful man who had so much humanity.
Will the world ever get tired of hearing about Elvis Presley, do you think?
Unless we blow up within the next couple of weeks. I think that Elvis will always be Elvis. And he will remain an icon, beloved.
Hi.
And in one second, ready to roll. One second.
And is she pretty?
Beautiful. Okay.
Elvis, I'd like to introduce you to Monique Brave from the Sioux Indian Tribe here in Rapid City, and Mayor LaCroix, who's got a presentation for you also.
Elvis, on behalf of the citizens of Rapid City and the community, welcome to Rapid City, and we appreciate you being our first concert in our new auditorium.
Thank you.
And this says so on our plaque. It's for your grand opening concert here. Thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you. Very nice.
And Monique?
Is she pretty? Hi, Monique.
Hi. This is a medallion of life for you, Elvis, from the Sioux Nation.
Oh, that's lovely. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. We're ready for Michelle. Michelle's going to be
okay. 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 Good luck to you, Elvis.
Somebody give her. We can give them.
I heard from people who are Elvis aficionados that they said that his voice had never been more beautiful.
Very rich and powerful.
Especially when he sang his gospels.
Mm.
That was the moment I think that he was close to God, he was close to his mother. Mm. And of course, he always said this thing. I mean, the one woman who meant the most to him in his life, we have to, is his mother.